Mia, for some reason we've got no picture. You have a picture? No. Yes. We have a picture. I just sat on the controller, Mia. Can you imagine those buttons and sticks of the controller up your butt? Mia, this is why I say, yeah, you ready? Fuck that guy. How can you get stuck in on Labyrinth for fucking half an hour, you dickhead? Right? Wait, why have we got no signal? I'm gonna put, the old style, just the non-HDMI one on. Because that HDMI one on that particular console, the back of the PlayStation where it slots in is loose. Because this is the one that plays discs. Next month, I'm going to get another PS2. Right? Because I know that you, I need to switch to AV. I know that the one that you've got, I'm not interested. We seem to be good. Let's start a new career because we lost our $3,000, yeah? And I don't really care for how the character looks. I'm not bothered. So we'll just make a new character because then we'll get full money. So this is going to be Barry number two. So Barry number two. Let me just turn down the speakers as well because we don't want an echo. There we go. So we're this guy with black glasses. That'll do. So we get $3,625 at the start of the game, right? Now, if we go on professional, like we was before, because we know how to do. Actually, that professional, it actually drops our money down. That's actually pretty funny. We got less money on professional as well. So we've got to make some good choices in some good spots. Now, I keep saying that a lot of the time, it's not about the cards that you've got. It's about who's still in the hand and how much money you've got and how much money they've got.
Okay, gang, so I'll be dealing tonight.
Chris Fergus.
Oh, this is
all. So we're the rookie, by the way.
I bet.
Okay. We just need to change the settings so that we don't have to peek at cards. So, game speed, medium, allow CPU skipping, yes. Auto peek at cards, yes. Next card came on. I don't know what always top down means, but four color deck, yes. Okay. Let's play some poker. Now then, what cards have we got? 5 and 6. And we'll call the 10. Because consecutive cards are always worth playing. And I'm going to try and tell you what I'm thinking and doing each time, right? Now, we can have people come into the chat and tell us we don't know how to play poker. You've seen me play poker for real life, for real money, and finish on a fucking final table out of 1,000 people so they can stop my balls. So don't listen to the people in the chat, Mia, right? So we've got 5 and 6, and now we've got an 8 and 9 on the table. So we need a 7 for a 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 for a straight. So we're looking for a 7, and we want to get in for as cheap as possible until we see that 7. We don't see that 7, we're out. So we check.
Hey, let's keep it interesting at least.
Now, that guy has bet 30. Yeah. We only have 100. Yeah. Are we going to pay 30 out of our 100 to try and see if that's a 7? Would you do that? But the answer is, if he has a pair of nines or a pair of eights, we are fucked. Yeah. So what we do here is we fold. We don't play. Yeah. We can't call it. Now, if we was YOLO, we would raise and hope that he folds, right? Now, this first tournament is basically a tutorial. So we can YOLO all in, yeah? He's thinking what to do. He went all in as well. I bet you he has an 8 or 9.
I call.
They're going to show the final cards. If we get a 7, we win by luck, but we probably lost.
Blaze
he had an 8. See,
pair.
I told you he had an 8 or 9. So you see why he went all in, yeah? Obviously, we got knocked out.
Hot damn.
But you see why I said that's why we fold. But now we get to choose which tournament we can do, right? So that's our warm-up game, yeah? So we've got 3,500 in the bank. So I reckon we go straight in.
Welcome to Tunica, Mississippi.
In the 1,500 tournament,
Grand,
yeah?
The largest casino between
and these cutscenes are nice.
And Las Vegas, and the first stop for the World Series of Poker circuit events. Tunica marks the first
I'm not going to do any stupid choices this time.
Points towards the veritable Pro Bowl of Poker, the $2 million Tournament of Champions. Players will
right.
receive...
So, the no limit hold'em 1500, this is what we're doing.
Looks like you'll be sitting down at a small buy-in limit event.
That's not the one.
Okay, you're in the $1,500 buy-in no limit.
Right then. Now we're playing against a lot of people. But this time it's for real. No messing about now. This is for half our money. We need to win in the tournament at least 1,500.
Players are getting set.
Right, we've got a pair of eights to start with. That's really good. And as you see, everyone's got 1,500, yeah? Now, someone's already bet 30, and then they've bet 80. Someone else is already in for 80. So we raise to 120.
And he comes out with a huge pile of chips.
There's four people left in. Right, he's matching my 130. He's matching my 130. If an 8 comes up on the table in the first three cards, we're all in straight away.
Why not?
Right, here we go. We're looking for an 8.
With a flop like that, it's sometimes just the first person to bet who takes
right.
the pot.
If someone has got a 10 or an ace, they're ahead of us, yeah? We've got a pair of 8s. We need to get some people out of the hand. So we need to bet like 300 or 400 here. We need them to fold so that we're up against less people, yeah? So we don't want them to call 300. We want them to fold, yeah? So Keith is still in. Carlos is out. Danny, what's he going to do? Right,
who's
Danny is all in.
All in.
Now, what could Danny have, right? So imagine Danny had ace-ace. So he'd have three aces. Imagine he had 10-10. So he had three tens. Even if we found another ace, we lost. I mean, an eight, we lost. I say we fold to stay in the tournament. And we hope that Keith calls so that we can see what they both had, yeah? So we got to fold to stay in the tournament. We won't win this. If Danny's got an ace, we lost. Doesn't matter what happens. So Keith, what are you going to do? Keith is out, so no one sees anything. So we'll never know what actually would have happened.
He chased everyone out and takes the pot.
Right, we've got 10 and 4, we're folding. And then we skip. Right, we've got 8 and 3, we fold.
Words with your chips, you're not going to be...
When we're in, we'll see what to do. So like, we can make back that, what, 500 that we lost? No problem. Right, next hand, queen and six, we're out.
Fold.
Go on and have it then.
Forge.
Winning's fine, line.
Queen and three, we're out.
Let the good times roll, man.
9 and 8 is consecutive. Let's see if we can get in for this for cheap.
I bet.
We're going to call to 30. So we're in for 30, right? So there's only me and this other guy. Now, Dave has raised it to 90. We can afford 90.
I'll call.
So now we've got three people in. What's Keith going to do? Right, we've got four people in.
A lot of these players like to stay in the pot. To
right, we've got 8, 9, and 10.
Let's see how many.
We need a 7
now.
Or a jack to come up right now, or we're out. Because there's two cards above our 8s and 9s, right?
No.
So that guy's gone for 370, so we're out. We're not playing.
Folds all around. Give the pot to him.
Fold.
Right. We didn't manage to get in for that one. Queen, King 7, we're folding. That 7 and 3, we're folding. Country. Seven and three again, we're folding. Right, dealer, come on, give us good cards.
Small blind,
king and seven, we're folding.
Minimum bet, they all just...
I'm folding this one. The British light.
Five and
two.
Right, we're already in. Or 10. Let's take the 5 and 2 because they're the same suit.
He's
let's go in with
play.
This one, see what comes up on the table. If someone does like a raise of like 100, we're not playing. Right, we've got 4 spades now. We need one more. So let's just check. Now, if Keith folds... The other two have got less than us.
Check it out.
So that's what position we want to be in.
Let's see how that affects the betting, Ron.
I'm going to bet 80. We want people to fold now. Bobby is in. He's done a raise.
Board shows a pair of kings.
Right, we didn't make anything now except from a pair of twos and kings, so we check. We hope everyone else checks. And then they'll just show down the cards.
Check, check.
He played that hand like it was gonna be his last one.
We were in second place, but we didn't win. It's okay. Alright, we've got ace and four. Let's go in for 120. The ace is the strong one here.
Oh, I'm folding this one.
I think we have to fold now.
Count me out.
We need to get some good cards.
Potential flush.
8 and 2 is rubbish.
Count me out.
Right, we've got 700. If we double up, we're back to where we started, right? Three and two, we can't play there.
He'll fold. Everybody folds.
All right, king and ten. This might be worth playing. Spending money to make. Let's go in for 60.
Have you ever thought of becoming a producer, dear?
How come it never seems that easy when I sit down to play line?
Let's raise it to 60 here. Let's re-raise the 220. We don't have a queen. We have to get lucky to get a king to draw, right? We've got two cards to draw. Three kings unknown. Let's go all in, and if we lose, we'll just do the next tournament.
He's going to push it all.
If the other guy folds, then we're good, right? Resolve. We get his 200. Right, that first one's out. Chuck, come on, fold. You can do it. He folded, right. So we actually won the hand. Right.
Scared everybody away.
That is when you go all in, Mia, to try and do that, right? So we've got 1,000 now. We've got a chance. We're not playing 5-3. We're gonna get busted.
That's it for me.
Count me.
Ace queen. This is a premium hand. We are betting 100 out of the block.
Players are gonna have to pay to see the cards.
You wanna see the cards, you pay 100.
That is one ugly flop.
Ace and queen is still higher than all of those. Let's up it to 200 this time. Because we've got four people in. We want to be down to one versus one, right? What are you going to do, Bobby? Bobby is out.
Check's good.
Okay, they both matched me. We got a 7. Let's check here.
He'll let somebody else jump first.
Is that everyone checking? Yep. There's my ace on the river. We got the ace now.
Or not.
Laurie is all in.
I leave the decision up to you.
Now, if she had 3 and 5, she's got a really good hand. If she had 5 and 6, she doesn't have a straight. There's no way she has ace-ace, right? Because we've got the other ace. It's very unlikely. So we're all in and we take her money, right? Like, how can she beat us? If she's got king-king, she lost. If she's got 10-10, she lost. If she's got 9-9, she wins. And she would have bet already, right? We call it.
Gambling for a reason. I call.
What's Randy going to do? I think we got this one because we got the ace at the end. Right, Laurie, what do you got?
Next one.
Error threes, yes. Right. See, now. I called her there. I was like, yeah, man. There's no way you beat me. So we got 2,620 now, right? All in a win after the river.
I'm out.
Right, we can't play king two, it's rubbish. Now, Danny Wong has got more than us, but we've got a decent amount at the table.
From the sidelines.
There's no shame in
you saw me go down to like 400, Mia. We got
there's
this.
A check.
8 and 3, we're not playing that.
Oh-ho.
4 and 2, oh, we're not playing that.
Not this one.
Nine and 7, we're not playing that.
Can you drop that hand faster than my second wife dropped me?
10 and 2, we're not playing that.
He tosses them in.
You see how we fold a lot, right?
You must think you're some kind of card player.
8 and 7. They're consecutive. We'll get in for this one. Right, we're in. Can we win?
I'll fold.
We got 6, 7, 8, 9. So we need a 10 or a 5 for a straight. That's what we're looking for. So we can bet 90. Just a baby bet. Everyone's out. We win. Jack and 10 of diamonds. So we're looking for some diamonds here. We'll raise it to 120. Someone's gone all in for 290. We'll call that. Everyone else is out. So can we knock Bobby out the tournament? We got it. We got 3 of a kind tens. So he got knocked out. Right, king, queen. This is decent. Let's go in with 90 here as well. Now, Keith has gone all in for 400, and Laurie is already all in, so we call that.
It's called gambling for a reason.
King Queen can be good. And we won. We beat both of those two people. That's another two people knocked out. We got an unlockable as well. We've got 3,670 now. And we're not playing 10-2. Forget it. What we are doing is opening cans of Coke.
Check it.
Board shows a pair of sixes.
King and nine. They're both clubs. We're looking for more clubs. We'll call their 90. If Danny's out, these other people are at risk and we can push them all in. We need to wait for Danny to fold. Danny is out. No, he's not. He's still in. I lied.
Some pretty faces out there.
Especially if you paired one, Norman. Pass.
Right, we've got a pair of kings. So, we can bet 150, I think, here is good. Now, Chuck has gone all in for 695. We'll call that.
He decides to call and a chance to knock out another player.
Chance to knock out another player.
Look, if you're ready to go home, I'm willing.
Danny's
to
in
okay?
for 695.
I'm folding this one.
Board shows a pair of queens.
He's raised for 1350. Is this guy gonna take us out? Ugh. We've got 1,000 less than he's got, so he can actually knock us out. I think we call 1350. We hope a king comes up now. Or a nine. We're not totally dead. It's a four. Now he's all in.
Somebody here is stupid enough to
so if he's got ace, if he's got ace jack, he's got a straight. He's got a queen, he's got three of a kind. Has he got one of those? If he's got a 10, he's got two pair and we win. And if he's got a queen, we're fucked. I think we go all in and we lose. That's what I think. I reckon that he's got ace jack. Or a queen. He had a queen.
Down to poker, I'd say that was a very big up.
Right, we got knocked
sometimes
out, but never mind.
It's hard to watch.
We've still got 1,500
like
for another one. And we are playing on hard. That because that guy was still in that hand, we got fucked. If that guy had have folded, we would have took that other guy's money and been on like 5,000 ourselves. So I guess we was just in an unlucky position. We couldn't walk away from that hand with the pair of kings. It's not possible. Oh, we've still got 2,000 left. I must have got... I didn't realise I had 2,000 left. We're still good. Right.
Okay. You're in the $1,500 buy.
I reckon we should be more aggressive. More bets. It's good that we get put in those positions, though, Mia, because that shows that like, it's a much more realistic game. Because that would happen in real life. So you'll actually learn things by playing against these types of CPUs, because these have got different personalities. This is definitely, I think, the best poker game on the PS2.
I will make a bet.
So we've got a 7 and 5. Let's get in there raising, right? 100. Because they're both clubs, right? That's another club. We're checking here. We hope he's coming in with an ace or king, right?
I'll start it right now.
Right, he's in for 270. We're all in, bollocks. And he folded. Right, so we're up to 2,000 already. So we scared him off.
He will lay it down.
So we got the most at the table.
With a flop like...
You all can go ahead and...
9 and 3 of diamonds, not playing that one. We would have had a flush.
All right, that's what I like to see.
9 and 2, we're not playing that.
He chased everyone out.
Ace and 7, let's get in for 30.
This
one is
and then I shall fold it.
World Series of Poker Tournament of Champions 2007. It's number game 4448 on the PlayStation, so it's one of the very last games ever released on PS2, which means the disc is still in good quality.
Check it.
We made our pair of aces. So I think that we can raise to 300 here. Because that guy's gone in for 150.
Let's see how that affects the bet.
We're all in. He folded. So we are already at 2,720. That's a good start.
Fold.
As long as we've got more than other people, we can't get busted, right? Jack and 4, we're not playing that. I like the controls of this game as well, where you use the left analog stick to decide what you're going to do. You can't just click X and accidentally call. You have to move the stick and then call. It's a two-handed game.
Bet now.
Four and three of clubs. Let's get in for 30 and see if we can win something here. Because they're consecutive and they're the same suit, so that's a good start. We've got ace and 4 and 3, so we need somewhat like a 2 or a 5. We can afford 150 to see another card. Gamba. Right, Nelson, are you in or not? There's a 5, so now we need a 2 for a straight, right?
Ah, you're all so boring, it's like it's always up to me.
I reckon we can call that 300. Is Duke out? Right, Duke is out. Where's that 2? Come on, give me a 2. It's a number 3. Oh, they check. So we can check as well. It's not going to cost us anything else. Now, what have they got? They've probably got an ace, right? Yeah, I thought they probably had an ace.
Adds to her chip stack.
So, I'm going to try and tell you what they've got before they show, right? And that's how you play poker. You try and guess what they've got. Now, we've got an ace here. Yes, we lost some money to that guy, but we wanted to see what he had. We're in for 100 because we've got an ace, right? As you see, aces are pretty good. Right, we made a pair of aces now, and he's raised for 310. So that means we're all in. And he folded, so we stole his money.
If the players aren't dropping fast enough...
Right, we're on 2,740. Lines just went up. We've got an 8-9 of the same suit. So we're going to call 60. We've also got an 8-9, a pair of 8s, plus that 10. So we're going to... We're going to bet 40. Small amount.
Call.
He's raised to 380. We'll call that.
He finds himself being bought.
Board shows a
That's three of a kind eights for us. Mia, this is the perfect time to show you how to do, right? Now, Warren, last time, he made a 300 raise, yeah? And we was like, meh. We'll call it. Yeah, because we have the 8, 9, 10, plus we have the pair of 8s. We've now got a 3 of a kind 8s. He made that raise before the 8 happened, right? There's no way that he's got 3 of a kind 10s. Won't happen. He might have a pair of 10s. If he's got a pair of 10s, he's in a world of shit. Because we've got 3 8s, and that's better, right? So what we do here is we check. When he bets, we raise him all in. And he's like, he checked as well. There's a 9, that is a full house for us. So 8, 8, 8, 9, 9, yeah? Now he's already in for 300. So let's make a bet of like 400. Something that he has to call if he wants to be in or he has to go all in. If he folds, we get everything.
I'll make the first bet.
Right, fold. He folded. So it doesn't matter. We got a full house. So we got a full house chip. So we're on 3,340 now. Right, queen 8, we don't play. That was a good hand to show you.
A lot of these players like to stay in the pot to...
Damn, baby!
Now, we've got a pair of 8s. We need to get in. So someone has already raised to 120. We raised to 240. We re-raise him.
Flops like this either see a lot of action or none at
now,
all.
Now, what's the chances they have king?
I got myself covered on that one.
It's raised for 760. We're all in. We've got a pair of 8s.
Well played hand.
Wow, that other guy had an ace-ace, but the guy with king, he got 3 of a kind kings with a 10. That's okay. We're down to 770, but we got unlucky. We're not playing 9-7. Right, we can get back up there, don't worry. I think we've been moved to another table as well.
Players might need a
5-5. We're all in with 5-5. We need to double up our 770.
Fold.
Doubling up all. But he had 10-10, he went all in. We had 5-5. So we lost. We haven't won anything. You reckon we need to go on medium difficulty, not expert? What do you reckon? We've been fucked every time we've played. Our balance is 500. Can we afford anything? That's a 500 in. Can we play this? Oh, you need 750. Okay. Let's do a heads-up tournament where we're playing against somebody else. We'll try and double up our money, right? So we're versus Mark Safe, right? Now, it's one guy versus one guy, right? So how do you win heads up? One guy versus one guy. This is a totally different way of playing. It's all to do with how much chips you've got. If you haven't got a lot, you're careful. If you've got a lot, you go ham, yeah? So we got 10,000 chips. And we got queen 8. Let's bet 150. Now, two cards over 7 is pretty good, right? He's called us. Now, that's a pair of 8s for us. He's raised for 200. So we're going to raise for 1,000.
Some possible straights out there.
He's checked. We're going to bet 3,000.
And he comes out with a huge pile of chips.
Mark safe has to fold. Yep, see? Fold. Now we've got more chips than he's got. So we've got 11,000, he's got 8,000. We've got an ace. So we're going to call his 200. We don't make anything else, so let's check.
Let's see how that affects the betting, Lon.
Let's bet to 700.
Let's do it.
We want him to fold. And he's folded. So now we've got 11-4 and he's got 8-4. So we've got 3,000 more than he's got. We've got ace-queen, so we call 50. We want him to bet here so that we can take his money. Ace-queen is decent.
Board shows a pair of eights.
We'll bet 100. He raised to 400 with a 9. Let's call 400.
Yep.
We want ace or queen to come up. There's our queen. So he's checked. Now, how much can we bet, right? He might have two diamonds, yeah? If he's got three of a kind eights, we lost. We're 3,000 ahead. So we bet 2,600. Just so that we're still ahead.
He is not wasting any time stoking the pot.
Mark safe. What are you going to do? And he's out. He folded. Now we're on 12K. And he's. You see how we're building a lead now, yeah? We've got 7-6. We're going to call 200. We don't want to bet too much. There's a pair of 7s. Check.
Check.
We want him to bet into us. Check. And then we'll raise him. That's our pair, right?
That should make somebody.
So we've got 6-7, 6-7. So we check. If we get a 6 or 7 again, we've got a full house.
Players have a shot at a straight and a flush. There's a check.
He checked as well. He's got nothing. 9 and 6. See. Right, we've got 8 and 10. Call 50.
Sitting in the small blind, a player can call at a discounted rate, and he does just that.
Now, we've got a good chance for a straight here with the 9 and 10 and 8. Let's make it 500. You want to play? You pay.
And we're off and running with an opening bet from the rookie.
We're no rookie. We know how to do. And he folded. Pussy. Ace and 8 of hearts is pretty good. Check. That is a pair of aces for us, so we're in for 300. And he folds. God, this guy's a pussy, right? He's only got 7,000 left. We got a pair of 3s. We bet 150.
Price is right. I call.
He's
baby.
Calling.
Board shows a pair of 7s.
He's raised for 400. We'll call the 400.
Three of a kind.
That's a full house for us, and he's raised 1,200. He's probably got an ace. And now he's all in.
It's all over, baby.
Do you reckon he's bluffing us? If he has an ace, he wins. If you have a seven, he wins. If he has a queen, he wins. If he has a king, he lost. You think it's a bluff? Call it. He's got an ace. I'm telling you, he's got an ace. He had four of a kind sevens. I did mention four of a kind sevens. It's okay. We got 5k. If we double up, we're back where we was. As long as you have chips, you're all right. We've got more. It got about half what we started on.
Board shows a pair of fives.
We can't play with king when there's an ace on the board.
Wow, every win feels like the first time over and over again.
So now that he's ahead, he's doing more bets, right?
Folds all around. Give the pot to...
He scared everybody away and earned himself the pot.
We're in for ace eight. Come on, why are you thinking, dude? He called me.
Shoot, I'll take a shot at it.
Let's see how that affects.
That's a jack.
Some spades out there.
We'll check as well. He had 9 and 3. Whoa. King and 8.
He will be the first one to stir the pot.
We need to double up on this guy somewhere.
It sparkles, Lon.
Here comes the opening salvo.
If we get a seven of diamonds, we've got a straight flush.
I call, baby.
Board shows a pair of nines.
I'll check it.
We didn't get that.
I'm going to check.
He checks. He had the ace of diamonds. Right, 7-6, we're all in. We need to double up. Badly.
He's going to push it all in and test his opponent's resolve.
Right, he folded. King 6.
He finds the price agreeable and calls.
That is one ugly.
Oh, we're all in. We need him to fold. Wow. He had a pair of twos. Right, how much did we pay to get into that? We was doing all right until he won that big hand with that four of a kind sevens. If he hadn't have got that, we probably would have won. I like this game because all we do is seem to lose. So we might need to try different tactics. Oh, we've still got 500. That didn't cost us anything.
Mm.
Not this one.
Enough of the shoving contest. Who wants the real deal?
She fought hard on that one and won it, Norman.
I wish shit at this today. We see what other games we've got on the USB stick. I'm just going to use my phone to test if any of these ports do work on this USB on this PlayStation. Because if they do, I don't need to use the other one. You know, I think it does. Let's see if we can get it out. Did you see that go to a bit less bright? When it went bright, that was not good. There's definitely something dodgy about both of these PlayStations, right? But they are like 20-year-old technology. The fact that they're still working after 20 years is a testament to how well they're built. That's what I think. The fact that this is taking ages to load probably means that this memory card is working in this PlayStation, which I thought that the ports were broken. Yep. So this is the this PlayStation plays from memory card and from disc. We have fixed it. This was not working before. Right then. This PlayStation did never boot Katamari Damacy, right? It wouldn't work, yeah, on this PlayStation. We have Shaun White snowboarding. We have Buster Move 2. The Buster Move 1, I think, is the one that crashes. Let's see. Buster Move 1 doesn't work properly, does it? Well, we've got blank screen of death. Blank screen of death, Mia. Yeah, it's not loading, is it? Right. If you remember the list, you can pick another game. You get to pick. So you see where it's quite bright on there? And then we go into here, it goes darker again. It's kind of weird, right? It's because of the software on the PlayStation. It's different than the other one. Should we see how bad Simpson skateboarding is? Are you scared? I'm not trying to influence you. I'm trying to get you to pick something. Oh, we haven't played Kingdom Hearts. We wanted to play that. I've got Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2. I've got Knockout Kings, which is like boxing. We've got Pool Paradise. And we've also got Pinball, but it's not very good. We've got Street Fighter EX3 as well, but I'm not really a Street Fighter guy. Let's try Simpsons and then Kingdom Hearts, yeah? Simpsons skateboarding, let's see. Have you played it? I understanding skateboards, right? So, I'll know after like 1 minute if the game is any good, right? Is that kid next to Lisa, the one that goes, ha ha? They've got to finish the game.
Lord Simpson at your service.
There's another bunch of, there's five people to unlock, right? You think he's called Ned? He, like, throws Bart Simpson's lunch on the floor and goes, ha ha.
Late Trevor 360.
Oh, man, this sucks.
May I recommend truck driving school? Nose grab.
Eep.
Remedial at best. Late shove it.
Yeah.
Get zoops. Mother would be proud.
My butt hurts.
That's it. Recess is canceled. Manual. Late 360 flip.
Oh, man, this sucks.
Simply awful. Simply awful. Ooh, 360 flip.
I didn't do it.
That was surely disgraceful. 50-50 grind. Board slide.
Just pay me now.
Wait till mother hears about that.
Oh, who am I kidding?
Late shove at 360.
Mess with the best, end up like the rest.
Well, I'll be.
All right!
Give that an A for awesome. Nose manual. Board slide.
Whoa, wicked!
Oh, wait till mother hears about that.
I was this close.
May I recommend truck driving school? Nice 50-50 grind. Crooked grind. Gutted. That's the old college try. Nose grab. Nose slide. Nose slide. Manual. Nose slide. Manual.
I'm getting this. I'm getting it.
You're looking at a lot of detention. Fifty-fifty grind.
I'm a shredophile.
Straight to the head of the class.
lake.
Shove it 360. Manual. Indie grab. Nice 50-50 grind. 50-50 grind. Late shove it.
I'm a shredophile.
Bravo. 50-50 grind. Manual. 360 flip. Nice 50-50 grind. 50-50 grind. Late shove it 360. Shove it 360. Shove it 360.
I didn't do it.
Perhaps some homework might help. Crooked grind.
Oh man, that sucks and blows.
This is going on your permanent record. Nice 50-50 grind. 5-0 grind. Maybe you'll do better next time.
We got 10K. You have won 10 cents. We won 10 cents, right? I got this.
Painful lack of skill. Shove it 360.
Whoa, wicked.
Straight to the head of the class. 50-50 grind. Nice 50-50 grind. Manual. Shove it 360.
Hey!
You should be in the special class. Manual.
Yeah.
That's no small potatoes. Nose manual.
Rough cow bar, dude.
Board slide.
I think.
He needs to get in the zone. That's what he needs to do, right?
Nice 50-50 grind. 50-50 grind. Late shove it 360.
Yowee!
Mother would be proud.
Get up!
I'm not so much angry as disappointed. Indie grab. 50-50 grind.
Just pay me now.
That's the old college try. Lake shove it 360. Tail slide. Nice crooked slide. Nice 50-50 grind.
His flips take too long. That's the problem.
You should be in the special class. Indie grab.
All right.
An A triple plus.
I'm the greatest of all time.
Mother would be proud. Indie grab.
What?
Get up, get up.
Remedial at best.
Are we stuck? How did he fall down there? We're trying to give it a kind of a good chance, but the way that it accelerates is different than Tony Hawk, right?
50-50 grind. 50-50 grind. 50-50 grind. Nice 50-50 grind.
Uh-oh.
I'm trying to press the buttons that you're pressing Tony Hawk, and that's why I keep messing up. Because it's not Tony Hawk, that's what it's not.
Loser.
What a shameful lack of skill.
Maybe we should do the training.
Nose slide. Nose slide.
Okay. I tried. The game's shit. Game's shit. Like, why the hell would you play that when you can play Tony Hawk, right? So, Mia, what is it? Game shit. You can tell Kieran that the game's shit. So, you want to see Kingdom Hearts, yeah? I'll tell you what is a good game. Fight Club. Have you ever seen Fight Club the movie? Have you ever seen Fight Club the movie, Mia? Right. If you know what it is, then this game is based on the movie. So, as you know, the first rule of Fight Club is you don't talk about Fight Club. The second rule of Fight Club, you don't talk about Fight Club. And the third rule of Fight Club is if it's your first time at Fight Club, you have to fight. Now, you're not going to get all the references because you have not seen the movie. But you want a spoiler of what the movie's about, right? So, think of, it starts out, this guy is like, It starts out, this guy is like, I couldn't sleep. I can't get to sleep. Insomnia is a bitch. And he goes to work and he's like, this job sucks. He has to do talking about insurance claims on the crashes, right? And he starts turning up later and later for work and going to support groups. And one of the support groups he goes to, there's this fat guy there that's taking estrogen or something because he had a testicle removed from testicle cancer, right? And he's got really big man boobs, yeah? And he's played by the character Meatloaf. The narrator, the main guy in the film, is played by Edward Norton. And the other guy is played by Brad Pitt. And instead of Johnny Depp, where you would find Helena Bonham Carter is Brad Pitt and Helena Bonham Carter. And basically, this Brad Pitt guy in the movie, he is an alter ego. He's everything that the other guy is. But basically, he teaches him how to make soap, to make a living by stealing animal fat and boiling it up, right? Now, it all sounds a bit crazy, right? And he goes to this fight club and fights other people and goes to work with different injuries and stuff, right?
The first rule of Fight Club is you don't talk about...
Now, the whole point is that the guy, at the end of the film, you realize that the other guy is also him. And that even though the other guy is sleeping with this girl, it's actually him that's sleeping with the girl, but he's so crazy on his drugs that he doesn't even realize. And the whole point is that throughout the whole film, the guy has schizophrenia. So it's what someone with schizophrenia, their life would be like. How they think and how they see other people. Like, on the one hand, he's telling his girlfriend to fuck off on the phone. And at the same time, he's sleeping with her at the same time as the other character. Do you see what I mean? So he's playing both characters at the same time, but they're played by different actors. And he's able to talk to the other character because he's talking to himself. Just see.
The first rule of...
So basically, there's quite a bit of fighting in the film at this fight club where he's fighting with himself. He's fighting against his own thoughts. That's the whole point of the film. It's a really good film. So let's do the story. I've already got Barry. I never managed to beat the guy, but you'll see that we're fighting against the guy that's got big boobs, right? Now, the loading screen is this blood dripping on the floor, which is realistic. It's very gory, this game. I like the blood on the floor. That's pretty realistic. So just see how the film is very complicated, and it's one of them sort of like Pulp Fiction or like Kill Bill kind of films where you've got to watch it like 4 or 5 times to understand what the film is even about. So it's a really good film. I've seen it several times, and I'm still trying to figure out what's going on. So we've got to beat this guy. I never managed to beat this guy so far. He's got some dangerous throws, that fat guy. Yeah, we're dead. So we're dead, see. Now we can retry. But I was quite close to beating him, so I'm quite happy. I've played this 4 or 5 times and lost every time, so. You've got to not get thrown by him, so I'm always backing off. See, look, we only got half life left. And we got thrown again. And again. See what I mean? The throws are very powerful. We can throw him, but they're not as powerful against him because he's fat and we're not that heavy. Now, I'm a martial artist, so my kicks are pretty good. Like, if I try and punch him, we'll just get busted. That's another throw we're dead. That's a broken arm. Like, got x-ray for the broken arm. We try and do some throws. I don't want to be close to him because he'll throw us. So far, so good. Stop moving behind me, you fucking hacker. He's out. We beat him. Right.
You're a great fighter. Tyler, I want to meet you when he gets back from Seattle with the shipment.
Seattle? Thanks.
Oops. Well, you aren't supposed to know that.
You should definitely watch the movie. It'll open your eyes.
I want to thank all you guys, alright?
Like, do you know that the guy that made the movie The Social Network, have you seen that? He made the same film. And do you know the guy that made a film called Seven? He also made that. Seven has Morgan Freeman in, and he's like the seven deadly sins. So like sloth, lust, gluttony. This guy's investigating murders, and it's got Brad Pitt in that as well. In fact, Brad Pitt is in a lot of his movies. This guy's Lou. Let's see what he's like. He's currently fucking us. Wow. It's a very hard game, this one. So we're just going to be stuck here now until we can beat this guy. Maybe I should go to the main menu and try and do the practice, right? Because it's the moves I don't understand. Like, Mortal Kombat is a different game once you understand that person's moves. Training. Isla Jack, Raymond Liu, Stern, Bob, Angel, Gavin, Mechanic, Ricky. Well, let's be Tyler versus Fat Boy. Let's try and understand how to do. That loading screen is so cool. The dripping blood. Alright, let's try and learn the moves in the training. Do you reckon it's crashed? How can you crash playing from USB, dude? I'm just gonna switch to PC for a second. And what I wanna show you is we'll just check Steam. And then right, this still isn't available in this country. Do you want to see this family's tree stuff, how I'm doing? Like, would that be interesting to do on a stream, right? So, how to find out? And I can show you where I'm at. So I have 729 people that are related to me. Yeah. So how does this work? Now, if I go down here and if I move these to the side and then go down, this is what I was explaining to my mum. This is my mum, right? So below my mum. So I'm gonna just gonna do like add relative So I added myself here. Now you can press this. And this here will be my full name. Yeah? And this here is Henty, this is correct. Now, what I can do is save this. Let's see. And then I can get rid of that. And then I can go view entry. Right? So it says I'm not dead. Yeah. And now I can add a father to myself. But anyway, if you go up above my mother, you'll see that these are my grandparents and that they're both dead. Yeah. Now, look at the date. 1939. So she lived for quite a long time, and this guy lived quite a long time, right? Now, this guy, his dad is called George, yeah? And this is his wife, right? I can go back, and his dad is called George, yeah? Now, I can go back. And his dad is called William, right? So, if you can compare to me, my grandparents, great-grandparents, second great-grandparents, third great-grandparents, back here. Then you get William Burtonshaw and Mary Burtonshaw. So you wonder, how did they have a William Henty? Right? Now, if you go to Mary Burtonshaw and go to profile, you can see that in her life story, she was born, her brother was born, her brother Ned was born and died away the same day. Right? Her brother George was born and died the same day. Her sister Betsy was born when she was 13. Her brother William was born. Her sister was born. Her sister was born. And then her son, William Henry Henty, was born. Now, she then married this guy when she was 23. Now, she was age 20 when she had William Henry. Right? Are you following? This, we believe that this is the dad. And they had that baby before they got married. And then they had, because he's a Burtonshaw, Caroline Burtonshaw, that they lived together here, etc., etc., etc. So what that means is, if we follow back the Hentys, her parents are Henry John Henty and Mary Ann Mitchell. Right? And then you can go up. He is Henry Henty. And then up here, there's no more information. Right? Now then, that is one branch of the tree. Now we can go to Gillian Ann Smith and go to her parents, and we can find John Smith, and his parents is John Henry Smith, John E. Smith, right? And you can go up. You always have to hide siblings when you do this because it gets confusing. Then there's Thomas Smith. Stephen Smith. Richard Smith had two wives, Dorothy and Sarah. Richard Smith's dad is John Smith, 1698. and there's no more information about that, right? Now, I believe that this person is wrong, because I've seen them in a different tree. So, that's two sections going back 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 generations. However, you ain't seen shit. Evelyn N. Smith, her parents is Harry Jackson, right? Jackson goes back to Thomas Jackson. He had two wives. Thomas Jackson. His dad is William Jackson. I think that this person is a mistake. I'm going to take them out. William Jackson. He doesn't have any parents. But he does. They just haven't been shown, right? And then you can go up via Anne Clark. And you can see that her dad is James Clark. George Clark. Now then. These two people, I don't know how that works. There's potential mothers and fathers here, but if they're potential, we'll add them in a second. But that goes to 1700. Now, there's even more. I've saved the best to last. Beatrice Wardle, check this out. Parents. Henry Wardle. Parents. Henry Wardle. Parents. Henry Wardle and Anne Snedden. Parents. Joseph Wardle, Elizabeth Topping. Parents. Isaac Wardle and Sarah Hallam. Parents. Richard Wardle and Anne Robinson. Parents. Robert Wardle and Marie. Parents. Lawrence Wardle. Parents. Antoni Wardle and Anne Wardle. Parents. Antonius Wardle and Elizabeth Bolton. Parents. Antoni Wardle and Mary Wardle. Parents. Don't have any further there, but Mary Wardle, you'll love this. Not her. My mistake. This guy. Elizabeth Bolton has a Peter Bolton, and he has no parents after that. That's as far back as that goes. But if you go across to here, you get Francis Wardle. Now, I can show you how far that goes, but look at the difference. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. This Antoni Wardle, 1555. This actually is fully related to me. As you can see, like that. Now, I showed you, I can find out where he's born. Now, we can Googling other people. And the reason you can Googling other people is because if we check this guy, which will go up here, this Catherine Snowden, if we look at her tree, now, she married Francis Wardle, who's in our tree, right? But look at this. 1500s, all of these, yeah. 1548 PB. 1539 PB. 1518 PB. This is the oldest person. Parents. Dorothea Broughton, 1510. Just happened, PB. Right? So these two people, I don't have any more information. That's as far back as that goes. That's crazy, right? However, we can't look at this girl because Francis is in the family. So even though that goes back further, the furthest back I've found is this. It was this Antoninus Wardle. This is the main one. Because I need to select this guy. So if we remove that, you'll see that this clicks all the way back to me, right? And it's going to tell you all the people that have been born from that one guy. Let me just finish this. So, from these two people, you can now see that they had this guy, that wife. This guy, that wife. This guy, that wife. They had these children. 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 They had these children down here. This line that goes down goes straight back to me. Do you see? Right? That is the height of the tree. How many generations is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15 generations. Now then, let me just go back to tree overview. Okay, now I want to show you some other stuff, right? I want to be able to close everything. Now, This Mary Wardle, right? We can click this to get some hints, right? So she was born in 1560 and died in 1658. She's the one that's 98 years old, right? So you can find out from this book, and it will say Mary Wardle, right? Look at this. Mia's like, wait, what? Anno Domini, 1657 just happened. So Robert Siddle baptized, yeah? Thomas Ford of Thomas Barons baptized. Sarah buried. What we're looking for though is we're looking for the name, Mary Wardle. And if it comes up on this, we can prove that that's her. So this is 1660. We need to look at the date. So the date is 1658. and this is the burial place. So we can go and look at the burial potentially. Me and my mum, right? Now, we just need to... we just need to do this. So, we're looking for Mary Wardle in this picture. This is 1659. There you go. MaryWardle. Mary Wardle buried. So Mary Wardle. This word here, yeah. So 1657. 1658. 1659. They're the dates of when people were buried at that church, right? This is the book of everyone that's dead. The book of the dead, right? So we're going to say that, yes, that is the right person. And we're going to go to this place. So, yes. Now, her children are those, let's see. Right, now, what we can do is we can Googling that. Yeah. It's an isolated village surrounded by farmland. Saint Michael and All Angels. The church dates to the 12th century but contains elements from 14th, 15th and 18th century. So let's Google this. This gives us some coordinates, right? No. This links us to OpenStreetMap. I can't go directly to there. If I just click on it. Yes. Right. Now we know where it is. So it's halfway between here and here. So let's put that at the side and let's get this open. Now we match one map to the other, right? And then we go here. Oh, wow. Imagine if you could read that from here. Saint Michael, All Angels. Is that the correct one? Saint Michael and All Angels. So this is the exact location. This is the exact location. We've done it again, right? Somewhere here is that 15 times great-grandmother, right? Somewhere in one of these. Now, how to find out, right? For sure. Now, this is obviously a little village, yeah? Like, there ain't many houses here. So, now we can go to this place called Find a Grave. And now we need to go to the cemetery location. Church Broughton, South Derbyshire. Like that, search. Now there is 37 records here. So you got Saint Michael All Angels Churchyard. 37 added, 68% is photographed. Right. We have Albert Charles Allen, Annie Morland Allen, David Allen, Lucy Roach Allen, Francis Edwin Allen, Lillian Allen, Samuel Allen, Trevor Allen, Thomas Bakewell. Blunt Bradshaw. Now he died only recently. Harry Dunn, 1899. This girl died pretty young, that's pretty sad. This one, 1701. But we're looking for 16 something. So very close by. Now I want to get that into a new tab. But this is the sort of quality of the writing you can expect. Right. Here lies the body of Elizabeth Fox, sister to Henry Fox. She died year 10 of April, Anno Domini, 1702, age 76. Right. If we can find that particular stone for the exact person, I can add that picture. Right. And then they've got typed out what it actually says. Yeah. So that's what I'm looking for when we find the person we're looking for. So this is Henry Fox. This will be her husband, right? Gemma Hinklin, Hannah Hinklin, Thomas Jackson, Private Thomas William Jackson, Moorcroft, Salisbury, Trevor Smith, Stafford, Tunstall, Twig, Vernon, Williot. So the name is not there, right? But that doesn't mean that's all the people that's there, right? Now, it says there's 37 here, right? But can we count more in the pictures, right? We want to be on the maps. So, 37, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. 24, 25, 26, 27. And there's a load over there, Mia. This woman has to be there. And there's all those over there as well. And there's all of those over there, right? Less than a quarter, no, all the way back over there as well, yeah? Not all of these have been written down, yeah? So, where is that in relation? So, what I'm going to do is, I did this on my mom's computer. What you need to do is go back here. You need to put a marker down. So, just here. This here, I'm going to add a label. I'm going to put Mary Wardle, right? And then save that. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you Anthony Wardle. So, apparently that guy died age 25. I didn't buy that. But he is in this location, right? So I know where that is. So if I zoom out, he is buried here. So that red dot there, and this one over here, is the difference of where they're buried. Now, should we try and find somebody else? So, Antonidas Wardle. Now, there's 1575 of when he was born, which was when this guy was 20. This guy, he died in that location. Where's the information? He died in 1605. And he was buried there. However, there's no date for when he was born there, but died in 1605. Is that even possible? This guy. That could be possible. And he had a son called Anthony Wardle here. Yeah, that is possible. Right, so we're looking at that one. He married Katharina Bridkirk. But this is Katharina Wardle. That can be exactly the same person. Now, this is a marriage picture, right? We can check this out, right? So what we do now is we close other tabs, because I've made those pins, right? And then we can click this and see on the piece of paper or in here, St. Margaret, York, York, England. Right, let's go back. And then go to this. And then we go to this. Anthony Wardle Jr., 12th of May, 1605, in Bilton. So if this was 1605, we can then rename. We can rename. This was this person. That was that person. That's that person. It's a different wife. Katharina Bridkirk. Married in 1594. So this Elizabeth Bolton person could be wrong. I'm going to remove that person. And then I'm going to add this person. And add here spouse, female. And save. Now then, there is information about this person, right? Now, we don't know when she was born and died, but now we can find out, right? So, what we can do now is some Uber hacks, right? Are you ready for this? We can add in their marriage date, right? That's first, right? Right, let's go back now. Now, what we can do is this Bridkirk person, right? If we click, we can go to hints. You'll love this. Other people's trees, right? So, new tab. And this is Kirsty Wardle. This person can be our new best friend. Because Kirsty Wardle is alive today, right? We can even talk to her, right? Open in new tab, and I'll show you why we're doing new tab, right? So what we do is now we go back and back and back back to here, and we're looking at this person. We put that over there, and then we get this one put over to the side, and then we put that one in there, and then we put that one in there. So we're looking at this Katharina, right? This view in tree. Now we see now their tree and our tree, and then we compare, right? Now that is confirmed that that is the wife, because they have the same person down here and the same person when they die. We got the sniper! That was the wrong wife before. Do you understand, right? We changed his wife and we printed. So now what we can do is in this person, we know the information of when they died. So I click here. And I quick edit. And birth was 1597, and the death was 1636. Save. Yeah. Then, because we know this person, they also have his parents. They should be the exact same two as this. Click that. Anthony Wardle, 1555. That is correct, right? I can remove these siblings. And Mary, 1560 to 1580. Now, we've got 1560 to 1658. And that can be wrong. Now, what they do have is they have this here. They have a profile. They say that he died as a young father, right? Now they've got here a marriage when he was 102 years old. That's wrong. Okay, let's go back. Now, you see these people and these people on both sides match, yeah? This is someone else's tree. This is not ours, right? Now, we look at some other people, their tree. So we go to this one, view in tree. Katharine Bridkirk, 1575. Antoni Wardle and Annie. If they don't know when they died, but we have the same details, yeah? Now, if we look here, we'll be able to see again that they know that this guy was born in 1555. But we know that he died in 1580. They don't know this person, yeah? Now then, I said that there was someone that would be our new best friend. This person here could be our new best friend. So they have Catherine's children, which is this. 1596 to 1643, that is the correct guy. This guy here, 1575, nobody knows when he died, right? But his parents, 1555, and they've got 1560 to 1580. Now, what we think is that I think that we need to find out what they've got written for this. Because I think that this date of death is wrong. And that this one is correct. Because other people have 1580. They don't have anything for that one, but this guy has 1580 and this guy has 1580. And we've got 1658. So if we rename that to 1580, and I'm going to change the death location and put it as 15. Is it 1560 to 1580? Yeah. These people both died very young. Right, let's put that, and we might be able to find more information. So we can now search for this person. This here is going to show us. Fifteen seventy-five. These two children. And then 1579. And then 1580. The year that she died, he had Francis Wardle. Now, there is a couple of other people with different family trees. A new tab. New tab. Now, it says they both died at the age of 20. Now, this person's got the three children. So let's view in tree. This doesn't go back any further. They had to have parents. Let's check the other guys. Now, if we can confirm when Mary Wardle died, if it is 1580, right? So let's try and do that. Let's go back. Mary Wardle. View in tree. Oh. Oh, wow. This goes back to 1400 Mia, right? Now, that's saying that if this was Robert Wardle, but that's the wrong year. And that they've got him living longer. And they've got Alice Fox, Daniel Wardle, Alice Chapman, Thomas Wardle, John Wardle. Prudence Wardle. This is different people. So what I'm thinking is, where they've done Mary Wardle here, they've picked the wrong husband. So this person's tree is wrong. Let me just get that over to the side. And let's go back to here, to our one. Because they've got a completely different husband. So someone is wrong. Where this Mary Wardle is here, yeah. Let me just put that to that side and put that one to that side. They've got a different husband, yeah. And their children is this guy. Now, did this person have a Robert Wardle brother? Andrew Francis. We have this. Do they have that? That's Daniel. Thomas. I'm trying to see if they use the same guy again. John Wardle from 1695. No. So wherever these people are from, these are different people. But they can go back to here. That's just the year of birth, right? They've got him as 1560. I don't buy that that's correct. So let's search her again. There's others, right? This is the one we think it is. What is this all about? Oh, this is the wrong year. This is 1847. That's the wrong year. And do you know what you can do? When you're in this search, right? You can actually make the birth year exact. Yeah? A fly. And that gives zero good results. So then you can move it to plus and minus a year. And then you can do it plus or minus 5 years. This is the only result. And this, I think, is the wrong location. Yeah, I think that's the wrong one. I think if I take out the death year, I think we don't know when that she died. These people have completely different names. You think it's out? Yep, it's out now. 5 o'clock. So we need to wake up Kira. We send him 10 messages till he wakes up. Mia, you accidentally call him on WhatsApp, yeah. But I do it. But I do it. But I do it, right? We'll hang up. He's got his Wi-Fi turned off though, because he's not getting these messages. So if he was asleep at 3 and it's now 5, he's not going to wake up, right? He's not on Discord either, right? I won't be able to call him on here. Why won't he wake up? Why did he turn the internet off at night? I don't understand that. I don't understand anyone that ever turns off the internet. I don't understand it at all. Why would anyone turn off the internet? You understand it, right? Why would you do that? What I need to do now, you see this location. You see this location. St. Andrew's Church, right? Yeah. And this place, East Riding of Yorkshire. All of these, including this one, they have no photo, but this shows that there's three of these. Four. And this one died in 1601. Have we got anyone that died in 1601? I'm going to change this as well to just Mary. Let's put it like that. I don't believe. Like, I guess that could be right. This only has Francis. This has Francis. This has Francis plus their mother one. And this is 1657 married. Now, how could these have got married in 1657 when he was dead in 1580? What's up, Lorenzo? Lorenzo, do you know anything about your family tree? Now, you might be thinking, what the hell are you doing looking at people that are born and dead in 1500? Well, these people are my 16th great-grandparents. So, great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandparents. That's crazy. And if you think I'm talking BS, I'll show you what I'm talking about. We're trying to prove and disprove anything, right? These people here, in this place, in this country, any of these 60 people can be the right people. Now, I'll just show you what I mean. I'll show you my family tree. So, this is me, Brad, yeah? This is my mother. And this is my grandmother, yeah? Right? If you follow through this person, and then through this person, Beatrice Wardle, now you'll see here how that's linked to me, yeah? Directly. Now you follow Beatrice, and you get Henry. You follow Henry, and you get Henry again. You follow Henry, and you get Henry again. Right? You follow Henry, and you get Joseph. You follow Joseph, and you get Isaac. You follow Isaac, and you get Richard. You follow Richard, you get Robert and Marie. You follow Robert, you get Lawrence. You follow Lawrence, you get Antoni. You follow Antoni, and you get Antonius. You follow Antonius, and you get Anthony Wardle. This is the furthest back that I can get. And that is how far it goes. Now, something else that's weird about my family tree. Check this out, right? My grandfather is called Henty. So how far back does Henty go? George W. Henty? George H. Henty? William Henty. William Henty's parents are William and Mary Burtonshaw. So the Henty name is gone, right? Well, no. Because Emily Jane Henty, if we look at her profile, you can see that Wait, hold on. I just want to, this is the wrong person, this Mary Burtonshaw, this is the person you need to understand, right? Her parents are Henty, you see that? Now, when this Mary Burtonshaw, right, you'll see that she lived to 90, right? But here's the problem. who's age 13, age 15, age 17, age 20. She had, at the age of 20, a son called William Henry. And then she married William Burtonshaw. And she continued to have children. So Caroline was born in April. This is May. So the following year, Caroline was born. And then they had a child, Barbara and Henry, etc., etc. Their first child, they called William Henry Henty. That's the point I'm trying to show. So the men does not continue Henty. She, Mary Burtonshaw, continues the name Henty. And you can go back to Henry Henty. And that goes back just to there. And this Susanna, right? Now, if you compare that to the Wardles goes back a lot further. Yeah? Now, if we close this and close this, this is the eight line grandparents, right? So you've got parents, grandparents, and then great-grandparents, right? These are the names. Wardle, Jackson, Roberts, Smith, Batchelor, Rose, Spicer, and Henty, right? Well, I'm the current generation, right? I'm right at the bottom. This is me. So, my point is this. Smith, John Henry Smith, right? You can go up. You can find Thomas Smith. You can find Stephen Smith. You can find Richard Smith. John Smith. And that's as far as I've got on that one. So that's not very far on Smith, right? So we can get Smith closed down. Now, Jackson. If we go up to Jackson, there is Thomas Jackson, William Jackson, and that's it. Not many, right? That's way more than three generations there. But I'm still working out on finding stuff. That's why I'm looking at things like this. So I can find, like, a gravestone, say, like, Hannah Wardle. And then I can read it. It's not very clear, that one. These ones are too modern. I want older ones to be able to read. Now, what does this say? Because this looks pretty old to me. You original. Francis Wardle. Now, this was one that I was saying to my mum, where Hold on. We might be on to something. How did I find this info? I got ways, man. Now, I thought that this row here, if I just copy this image. Now, MS Paint is your best friend. Is that right, Mia? Are you still here? Yeah. MS Paint is your best friend. Now, here, I thought this was Roman numerals, yeah? But this is not. This says Rebecca. So this would be the wife of Francis Wardle. That's what it says below, right? Now, do we have a date for this? St. Cuthbert Churchyard. And then I went back. Birth and death dates unknown. Now, this is what I would do next, right? And I've showed Mia this, how to do, right? We go to this location. Now then. This is the most northerly one we've found. Now, we're on this road from Grindale to that Eaton place. So now we need a new tab and throw that tab over there. So what we're doing is we're trying to find this location on actual Google Maps. Because I've found two other locations that actually happened. Right, so now then. Because I've got a location that is just over here. This location is where we think that this other woman is buried, right? And I also know that for certain, 100%, that there is another guy that's over here. Just here. That's his wife, yeah? Now, I don't believe that they died age 20 so many miles apart. So I'm trying to find this person that's slightly more north because they're to do with this guy called Francis. You see here, this guy. This is the child of that woman. If this child is buried in that graveyard, his fucking mother is buried in that graveyard. That's what I'm telling you. In 1500, they didn't have cars. They didn't have trains. They didn't have aeroplanes. They didn't have electricity. They're not going to be very far away from where they were born, right? So, anyway, we're trying to find this location. So this location is here, between Grindale and this place. And it's off from Hinderthorpe here. Where it curves in. Is that sewer be there? No, we're further up. It's up here. Grindale? Ruston. This is in the middle of nowhere, and that's what's so amazing. Here's the Grindale. We follow this road. That's it. Front Street. Here it is. This location, right. So let's have a walk around. See what we can do. So we found the location. I'm going to tag this location because this is one location I need to go to. Now that does look like the sort of age that I'm looking for. That looks 500 years old. That is good. Right, let's tag this area. So we're tagging it just here. Ah, I need to get off street view. So we call this Francis Wardle. And now we go and have a look. Let's have a good walk around here. Because if we can read these from the road, this is how we do this. Now, these are very old, yeah? So let's have a look. Let's start from one area. Wow, I thought that was a lion. But they're actually cows. So let's start over here. That one's easy to read, but that's not the one we're looking for. We're looking for that big one up the side. Not that one. It could be that one over there. Now, has someone chosen to block that area? Because they don't want that to be red. What could possibly be there? There's a dead tree. Ah, that one could potentially be readable. These are all in England, in the UK, right? So someone doesn't want us to read that. They've asked Google to block that. Bollocks, man. I'll go there and photograph it and change Google. Now, it could be this one. You can kind of read that. Is that the one on the side? Because what we're looking for is we're looking for... this. There. There's them two bits like that. Let me just put that on that side. That is the same one, yeah? Are you agreeing? I think we've got a DNA match there. That's the same from a different angle, right? We found it. Damn, I'm good. And that right, Mia? Damn, I'm good. Look, at it, even down here, this part, that matches 100%. Yeah? That's the one. However, there's grass here, and we're closer, and there's like a little ditch. You see how this goes down? And we wouldn't know that unless we was close by. Yeah? Because the bottom there is exactly correct. So this is Francis Wardle, right? Now, obviously, we can get a little bit further down. Wow. We can't really make it out. You need to go there. So now we know that's the correct one. Let's look around. This brick was invented hundreds of years later. This is not the original wall on the outside. These two are identical. Now, are you amazed that the My Family one is the only one that's attached to the side of the church? So one would assume that they may have even owned that church, or at least been one of the richest families around here. Right? Has to be. Nobody else has got anything like that here. Would you agree? Now, do you want to know something interesting? This is the family crest of Wardle, yeah. And there was a village in Bunbury here, and they think that the people came across from where is it? The Yorkshire Poll Tax Rolls list this guy. Now, if I can get from 1500 to 1379 and prove that this is the guy, right? and then there's here. The thing is, with older English, this name Wardell or Wardell is spelt in different ways. You see here? And then you see here. And then you see even here. Because, like, Johann is the same as John. But as speech and writing has changed. Now, I can tell you now that these people in the 1500s, 1200s, 1000s, I doubt they could even write. Pens weren't invented, yeah? Let alone read. There weren't that many books around. So it's just how you think it needs to be written, yeah? For the person that's supposed to write these names, yeah? So as language has evolved over hundreds and hundreds of years, that's why there's like Weird, Ward, Wardell. Wardell spelling variation. Only in the last few hundred years that the English language has been standardized. For that reason, Anglo-Norman surnames like Wardell are characterized by many spelling variations. This is what I was just saying. So that tells you what you need to know there. Notable people of the Wardell family. Anyway, so that's what you need to know. That it's the origins are in England and Scotland. Yeah. So somehow they can afford to have that on the side of the church. The only family in the village. Now, if we look at the MS Paint, can we decipher anything on there? Let me just bring up the MS Paint. So this is Rebecca, and then this is Francis Wardell. What is the top bit? Francis Wardell. That is Wardell, Francis. And because they also have Francis Wardell here, this is him and his wife. Now, I'm looking for Rebecca and Francis. Now, what we can do is Google that. We're on the wrong part. I need to be over here. This is a different website. Yeah. This is where I was the other day. This is where I first found the Wardells, right? And I was filling this in. I'm in another one as well, right? So, like, if I went to hold on, this here, right? And then I go to this this is a different website. I'll just show you how this works. You see how this one is filled out, and you've got a few pictures over here, blah, blah. Henry Wardell, Henry Wardell, Henry Wardell Sr. And then this goes up, James Wardell, right? Now, that was as far back as we got on that website, and that shows the breadth of the family tree, the whole lot, right? I don't know if you can see that well. But I don't want to be on there. Ancestry is a lot better. So, we're looking for a Rebecca and Francis Wardle with IS. Yeah. In the Wardles. So, let me just go back to the tree. So, I want to close off Jackson and go back to Wardle. Now, are we seeing Isaac? We're looking for Rebecca. So there's Richard and Anne. Robert and Mary. Lawrence. Anne and Anthony. Katharina. Now, I'm telling you now that these people could not afford, right? But we will have over here Margaret, Andrew, Francis. This one here. But this is the wife is Catherine. Now he could have had a child of Francis. Ellen, Marjorie, Stephen, Thomas, Francis. This guy. Now he died Old Malton, Yorkshire. In 1666. This could be the guy. Now, does there look like there's a 1666 on here? Because once you get a verifiable confirm, you can then do other things. If we could confirm that he had a Rebecca wife, where was I? This one. That was Catherine. Then I looked at his children and here it is, this one. So now we need to look at this. Did he have a wife, Rebecca? So that's Anne. Anne. Catherine. Now, it's not looking like he had any children there. But this would have turned into Anne Wardell, right? Married in 1634. Died in 1659. And this person is buried here, but their wife is different. Their father is spelt like that. That's not the same person. But this is what you would call a first cousin 12 times removed. A first cousin 12 times removed. We will find out that person. We need someone with Rebecca. So let's go back. So Francis, can we prove he had any children? We know that he had a wife. If we can add the wife. Let's add the wife in now. So his wife had to be Anne, right? Because both of these say Anne. So I'm going to use this. And if we open in new tab. Catherine Snowden Wardle. Sibling Abraham. Was there an Abraham on it? We know where we need to be, so we need to go up here. And got him. Right, that doesn't have to be the one, right? It was further up here. Where is it? I've lost where it is now. 1659. Where is that Francisco? Are we blind or something? We had it. Is it from this guy? Ah, here it is, from this guy. So we go down. And then we found this Francis guy. Now, this is the one we want to add the wife to. So, I'm going to add spouse. And the person that we had was Anne. And we also know what about that person. Ah, their sibling was Abraham. That's what we wanted to check. So if we save... Is there an Abraham? Abraham.
Got.
So that's two confirmed joins. Francis Wardle. Parents Francis Wardle, 1589. Yeah? Does that also match? 1580. So that is slightly different. Slightly different is okay, because one of the Lorenzo, that's not how things work. Being the last generation. I'll explain how things work. I'll tell you how many people in my family there is. Right? So... there is a factorial of 9 times the amount of generations you go back, right? So if this is going back 12 generations, we need to get, we'll say from here. This is how many people are related to me on Earth right now. So I'm very far away from being the last generation of my family. Now, how do I know that it's factorial 9 times 4? How do I know that? I have a piece of paper that I writ out exactly how many ways that there can be nine generations of people and how many people you would get, right? So let me just get that picture up. Hold on. I wrote it out the other day. And Mia might remember this. Because I showed him. Just scrolling up. Like, I'm not going to show you my entire WhatsApp chats because it's none of your fucking business. So I'm just going to show you the picture that I want you to see. I'm almost there. I say a lot on WhatsApp, so a lot of scrolling. Right, we're just coming up to it now. Here is the picture. Now, this shows nine generations. This shows that going back nine generations, you had to have exactly a mother and father every time, right? You can't just get a fucking cloned child in 1200 BC, right? Not possible. Now, let me see if I can copy this image and put it in the paint so it's rotated, because not being rotated is annoying. But I do need to keep this picture. So I'm going to save this as desktop. I don't know when he was, but so I can just rotate. And we need to rotate it, flip 180, and flip horizontal. Right, so this is my writing, yeah? If someone over nine generations had one child every time, there would be 512 people, that there is 256 parents, 128 more parents, 64. So that's how many people there is descended from two. Yeah. Now, if they had two children each, it would be a factorial three. So there would be 19,683 people related to that person if they had an average of two children. If they had an average of three children, there would be 264,144. Now, these numbers, 4, 16, 64, 256, 124, 4096, 1634, 65536, these are 32-bit integers. Yeah? So you might have seen 4096 megabytes of RAM, 64-bit computer, yeah? 1024 megabytes in a gigabyte, yeah? That's where them numbers come from. 65,536 ports on a computer. That's where all, if you have 16 gigabytes of RAM, it's 16384, right? So that's where all their numbers come from. Now, if they had an average of four children, which is quite low, yeah, quite low, and I'll show you why it's low, they would have nearly a million ancestors, right? Now then, why is that important? If you look at this family tree, and then you go, if I go back to just here, I want to show you something. If I go across to siblings, three, yeah? His children. His children. His children. His children. His children. This time there's 9. This time there's 13. Now, not all of these people, their children are filled out, right? So it's kind of crazy. He had 12 children, that one. Yeah. So you can even see in order, yeah? 37, 41, 44, 47, 48, 50, 53, 55, 57, 60, 61, 63, 52. This cannot be possible. 1875, this person is the wrong years. So this would have to be 1852. We'll fix that. Right, fixed. They had 10 children. Now, you see how many families has gone into this. Now, a blue person is someone that's a male, yeah? We go to Henry Wardle. He had 7 children. Beatrice Wardle had 5. Evelyn had 5. Obviously, these are spouses, yeah? Spouse, right? This person had a child. This person had a child. This person had a child. There's more people in my family, but I'm not showing the whole thing. I'm just showing me and my mom, right? I have 2 brothers and 2 sisters. That's 5, yeah? My mom has 1 brother and 1 sister. That's 3, yeah? So what I'm saying is, from the very top, if we added every single child and followed every single one down, there's over 1 million. So there's no point in doing it. Like, I could probably work this out to say that I'm related to you in some way, yeah? Even though you're Lorenzo Dominguez, nothing to do with these names. But I could probably find it, right? Everybody is related because we're all human. Now, that's just a fact of life. How related, no one can really tell. I'm telling you now, though, that these two people up here, Anthony and Mary, yeah, these are related to a lot of people down here. And this isn't even fully filled out. Because this is only their children. So if I added their children, added their children, added theirs, it'd gone forever. It's crazy. So what we are trying to do, though, is learn who in that is this guy over there. And that's the sort of thing that I can learn by actually going there and reading it for myself. It's a lot harder to read a photo than it is if you're actually there. If you can put your hands on it and feel it, you can even use like chalk, like black chalk on paper, because you wouldn't want to damage it at all, right? You would use black chalk on paper and make like a rubbing. Now, I can show you what that looks like. So you have here.
Takes a simple need specials. With clear split deep lines for the best results. In the grave process. Clean the stone. Dirt, grime, and stains to create possible rubbing. Only plain. Cover the head. Tape. Paper. was proved. Valentine. Folk lines. And then spray it with. Fermentation. Did you know?
So there you go. That's how to do it. Now, you don't have to do that if you just read it. Because some of these are a lot more readable, like that one just there. It's just we're not close enough. I want to go down here and have a look if we can see if there's any other ones that are attached to the side of the building. Like this one's definitely readable here. That looks like it's not in use, right? But that fence there looks pretty modern. This has fresh flowers there, so that's not that old, that one. Really bad pictures around here. You know, since these are outside, you would assume that's still in use, right? And this one's really badly fallen apart. So yeah, my mom is fascinated by this as well. So if I just show her this, and I'll be like, you see this graveyard here? You just come down here. And then I'll be like, if you look over there at that, you cannot read it. And then I'll say, dun, 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 dun. Check this. And she'll be like, wow. See, this is how you find out about the people. When you find out when they're born and died, you can find their like birth certificate and stuff. So it's a long, drawn-out process. Takes weeks.
Yeah.
Like, we haven't got this far in, like, one day. It's taken ages to get this far. Now, if I can prove that there is 1666 on here in some way, we know this is Rebecca. I just can't read that from here. If I was actually there, I might be able to read it a lot better. Like by squinting and stuff. I just can't make out what that says. But you can definitely see that says Francis Wardle. Why did I open? I got so many tabs open, it's not even funny. Reload. So we think that particular one is Anne Hood, but we want to know if they had any children. So let's search on Anne Hood. Married Francis Wardle, who died in 1666, had a child called Anne. And this is Old Malton, Yorkshire. This Angleterre means the UK, England. Anne in 1935. Father is William. Bows, France. And they've got Mood. William. I don't believe that their father is called William. This person also says that it's William. These are other people that have got family trees. So what we do is we new tab this. We new tab this. And then we new tab this. And then we compare those family trees, right? So this is a William Wardle, they think. But then this Francis Wardle goes Francis and Anthony. That's correct. This Catherine Snowden, if we went back, is that Catherine Snowden there? This is how you have to find out, right? So up here, you'll see Anne Robinson. And we need a Catherine. Catherine, that's there. Catherine Snowden, is that the one? Snowden. 1590 to 1662, 1580 to 1662. That is not a mistake. By saying that that there and that's his wife. So that's the same that it is here. Right? But they're saying that this person is also William Wardle. This part is correct, and this is other spellings. They've got 1590 on there, so let's look at that profile. Ah, they've put 1580 or 90. I see. Now, they got all that information from there. Right, let's look at this person. View in tree. Francis, they've also got William. Anthony. And this here is correct. With this person, we've seen this multiple times. With this person died at the age of 20 and this one died at the age of 25. These two people, it's really controversial that they died so young. Now, these two people didn't just drop out of nowhere. They had to have parents as well, but I can't get any further back. So this Anne Mood is correct. This Anne. And there was another Anne that they had, same name as her. But because she married William Nendrick, these are all Nendricks. So this is a completely different line going downwards. Get back up to here. So this Anthony and Mary, even though they only lived 20, 25 years, they can go onto a completely different tree by this woman marrying that guy. That's how that works. Okay. So we had another one. This one, view in tree. Nendrick, Nendrick, Story, Wood, Nendrick, Nendrick. By following this down, this shows that this person is a Nendric person. See? Kimberly Denendric. So this follows all the way down into the present day, right? These Nendrics. Now, it goes through here. I'd assume it's this one. Or this one. Now look at this. Look at the size of this. All of these people also come from here. So just these two people. All of these at least are related. Crazy. None of these people I've ever heard of, though. They're just from the Nendrics. Just from this one guy. Nendric. They don't know that this person was 1555. That's one thing they don't know. So what else can we find out? I can't go back from... That's from, so this was Mood, not Hood. This is the date of marriage, 29th of June, 1634. What day is that? Is that a Saturday? June 29, Saturday. No, that's a Sunday. They normally get married at the weekend, yeah. They normally get married at the weekend. Right, would you? This is the one. Yes, I will add that. Right. This is a different location. There's no way that they're buried in Cambridge. Absolutely no way. About 1653 death. Is that right? 1666. That's the wrong death. Anne and Francis. Because I'm looking for places in Yorkshire. I'm not looking for places in Cambridge. That one's not right. Now, what can we find out about this? There's no picture for that. We can't read that. We're looking for a Francis Ward over it. Because that's what we've got in this picture. But that Francis needs to be something to do with Rebecca. We will find out. One way or another, we will find out. So we can search for Rebecca. Rex Wardle. That's not Rex. We need Rebecca exactly. Dorothy Rebecca Wardle. But we need a Francis listed in here, right? Now, this is died in 2004. That's far too recent. This is 17. Child Mildred. This is in Cambridge. We don't want that. Here. What is this? Warren? Wardell. Yeah. Now this is marriages in 1874. Are we seeing Rebecca? No. So that's not right. This is Rebecca. This is in Hull. This could be the person. There's a chance, but this is only in the 3 months in that particular year. It doesn't have to be exactly correct. What's up, crazy collectors? How you doing? I know we've got the wrong title for the stream, but that's just tough. I don't believe that's the same person. East Riding. This is the right location. Holy crap. Here's Rebecca. And over here, this is the other spelling, right? All of these people in this list here. Matilda, Maud, Robert. Robert's pretty common, yeah? We're just looking for people in this particular area. Go back. See, you can find anything if you know what you're looking for. This one. What we've got in here. Now, sometimes this writing is so hard to read. It's so bad, that right, and I can't even make it out. We might need to put that they have a particular husband. So, we can edit and we can do gender female, add spouse, Francis. That might help. But in before it gives no results now. That's 1926. So I'm going to narrow it down. Now, this is people that died in 1926. Rebecca, aged 88. Now, if you look here, there's loads of zeros. This is people that has died as soon as they're born, like stillborn. 0000. So many. Like, kind of sad, really. Ronald, this person died when there was one. Because so many people used to die as soon as they were born in that kind of timeline. And even in 1926. But I think that this is too recent. I need to find out a death like at least 300 years ago. So let's put on here death. Let's put like 1700. What about this? 1793. Mouse is George. No. Mouse has to be Francis. Has to be exactly Francis. This one is 1740. Christopher, wrong guy. This is a birth with Dorothy and Jeremiah. That is in the wrong location. Johanny. Is this the same as this other person? I need to go to here. We're looking for... Not Isaac. I thought I saw one that said Johan. Joseph. Matthew Reginald. Johan, this guy. That could be his wife. Rebecca. 1637. Does that check out? This is 16. If this was 1637, I'm going to add that. So it will be 1637 minus about 20 years. So 1617. Now, is it possible for him to have been here at 1617? She would have been 20 years old had she given birth to him at 1617. And this guy is 1613. That is so close. That's so close. So you can see, Mia, how we can just add small little baby details. This person could potentially be this. I mean, this says father, so this is going to be the daughter. So let me just see. If I change this to Johani. This guy. Now this says Anthony, that's wrong. I don't want to do that, Council, that's a mistake. This here needs to add a daughter called Rebecca. So I need to add child. I'll never find that without proper dates. We need to go back. What's up, Mike? You want to see how crazy my family tree is? That is me, my mom, my grandmother, her parents, Harry Jackson and Beatrice Wardle. Over here, Henry Wardle. Zoom out. Henry Wardle again. Henry Wardle again. Joseph Wardle. Isaac Wardle. Richard Wardle. Robert Wardle. Lawrence Wardle. Anthony Wardle. Anthony Wardle. Anthony Wardle. I can trace this back to 1555. When electricity hadn't been invented, the internet hadn't been invented, cars hadn't been invented, bicycle hadn't been invented, the fucking radio hadn't been invented. Nothing had been invented. That is a fucking epic family tree. And it looks like a number four. That's just off one side from this person. Mike, is the tube on strike today? It was on strike the other day. Again. Why do I was on strike? They get 30k for sitting on their ass all day. Oh, this is much easier to read. That definitely says Johannes Wardley. Sepulter Hewitt. This is the old English writing. Mia, are you seeing this? This is when the English language changed. Because it looks to me like this is not English. But I understand what this says. Like Lydia Rogers. Anna Villa Spuria Elizabeth Foster. Johann Chambers. Nicholas Glossop the Wood. Peter Sarah. Sepulter Fewitt. Let me just Google it. Latin. That's what it's written in, right? 59k, Mike. So here you go. In Latin. Vidus means widower. Yeah. Sepulter Fewitt mean was buried. This is very important. So what that's saying is that this book is written in Latin. Now we know. So this Johann Sepultus Elt. Is that what we searched for? If we put Elt. Berry. Is that actually Elt? Or is that Est? Because there's Erat and Fuit. F-U-I-T. This is Elt. Let me search for that. else is not correct. Let's keep that Latin over there. Oop, I went onto the wrong screen. So we're looking at which one? This one. Is that est? E-S-T? She was buried. Now we understanding. So that's J-O-H-A-N-N-E-S. Johannes as a woman. Yeah. So she was buried. And the other one, F-U-I-T, is he. Yeah. It just says was buried if it's a man. Yeah. She was buried. Learning Latin with Brad. Yeah. Just happened. Learning Latin with Brad. Just happened. That's crazy. Now, what you also notice is you can tell by these books if it was a cold year, right? So you've got 1709, yeah? March, April, and then February. Because the year runs from like the end of March to the end of March, right? So three people died in 1709. A hell of a lot of people died in this year around the winter. December 4, December 30, February 3rd, February 2nd, March 1st, March 2nd. Now, whoever's written May there didn't write it properly here. But I must admit, this person's writing is good for 1710. Like, it even gets better over here. This is Helena Johnson. Now, why are they still writing in Latin in 1700? Anyway, guys, I'm going to get going. I hope you've been interested in what this is all about. I'll see you later. We will be doing Sonic later when Kieran wakes up. But he's asleep, and he missed the Sonic Origins start. I told him Sonic is out, and he won't wake up. Idiot. He turns off the internet when he's asleep. Can't believe it. Why would you do that?